Let's view another AI patterns to see if we can find situations to use artificial intelligence. Another situations. Imagine that you have a bunch of data, input data, that could be text, image, doesn't matter. But your action here is to produce new data. Your action is to produce maybe a summary. You have an article, a text data, yes, you have an article, and you want to produce a summary of that article. But not just one. Imagine that you have to read 100 articles and prepare 100 summaries. Or you have pictures in one position and you need to create new pictures. The same kind of object, but in a different position, for example. You want to augment your data. Or you want to create new pictures similar to the one that you have, but completely different. New picture. Or you want to produce sound. You have a text and you want that text transform in speech, in spoken language, and not only text. This is an opportunity to use the pattern of AI generation. Yes, you will use again natural language processing, computer vision, it doesn't matter. But here we are changing the action side, not the decision, but the action. And as you can see, the feedback comes not to the decision, the feedback comes to the action because what we want to improve, in fact, is the generation of the action and not a decision in this case. Okay? Another example, imagine that, okay, we have seen that we can use artificial intelligence together to augment your abilities to make decisions, yes, and use artificial intelligence to predict. But imagine that this model is becoming better and better and better in prediction. And you said that, no, I don't need more to take part of this loop. I can automate this judgment and I can create an algorithm, for example, to take the decision, a code, yes, programming. The decision will be taken accordingly of, for example, the prediction that you receive on top of the data, the input data. If the prediction, for example, it's greater than a threshold that you define, in this case, imagine 85%, you automate the decision and make the decision. And you can also automate the action. Yes, you can use programming, traditional programming, or you can use robotic process automation to automate. Maybe part of that was a human responsible to complete the task, and now you automate it with artificial intelligence and traditional programming, all the elements of these tasks. A final example here is, imagine that, okay, you are not dealing with a web page, an application, you are dealing directly with a client, with a customer. And the customer is in front of you and is giving you information, or the customer is in a phone, or the customer is using a chat and want to deal directly with a human. How can I use AI in this kind of situation and maybe change this human-human interaction to human-machine interaction? Then imagine that the client will continue using spoken language or written language. We could talk in here about an email, for example, or we could talk about a message, a chat. Yes, or the client could call a call center or using a voice assistant to talk with your company, your business, for example. Then you can replace all these tests that you as a human do, yes, by, for example, an AI to make the recognition, to convert speech in text, another model of AI, for example, to predict what is intention that this client has, what is his problem, what he or she is asking for, and then an algorithm, for example, to take the decisions, yes? And you can use AI as the generation to prepare an answer. Imagine that this is a chatbot. The answer could be a text. You can generate a text to accomplish a very good answer to the customer. If this is a voice assistant, the answer could be in a spoken language. Yes, you can transform your data that you have to present to the client, but in a spoken sentence, and the client can hear disinformation. Again, this is very tough. This is very, very, it's very complex to build, but it's completely affordable these days that we have platforms like Alexa, Google, with chatbots, with all this technology that we are seeing. In this module here, we see three additional patterns of AI that could help you to figure out what kind of situation you can apply: generation, automation, or human-machine interaction.